Do you have plans for the property right now, Sugarloaf? Specific plans, including a ski hill?
I have some ideas. But nothing's finalized yet. I mean, we're certainly going to build a resort, probably in a 4-star type resort. We'll nationally flag it. The ski hill presently has to be basically gutted because nothing on there, you know, can work. We're doing that now.
Mm-hmm.
Whether we put another ski hill together or not, we're doing crunching a lot of numbers to see if that works. Don't know that answer yet. The landing strip's gonna go. That I can promise you.
Okay.
No airplanes next to my hotel.
Okay.
And because I saw Garp, and I still think of that scene.
That's right.
We will do some wine there. Mm-hmm. Not really for retail purposes, but for purposes of use in the hotel and our other hotels in Michigan. And
okay.
Create a brand there.
Oh, nice.
For that. If I really have my druthers, I'd love to have a distillery. That's a personal thing.
That'd be nice.
I don't mind a good scotch or a whiskey. So those are things that I tell you that we're definitely going to do. When I talk about a resort to me is a little different than a hotel.
Right.
I mean, I'm talking about a place that's, you know, it's going to have a spa, it'll have some restaurants,
mm-hmm.
some retail in it. I mean, we're talking about doing a higher-end piece there. You don't have anything like that up here.
Nope.
And you need it. You need it badly. So,
agreed.
That's what I'm thinking about. A place where, you know, you want to take your spouse
mm-hmm.
and have an adult weekend type thing. We'll have things for kids too, but I'm really uh-huh. thinking of something, you know, classy and nice and homey.
And year-round.
And year-round. It has to be year-round. And so one of the issues with skiing is if you're known as a ski resort, people don't think about you in June.
Exactly.
I want brides here in June.
Right.
You know, getting married out here. So
yep.
we will come up with concepts, and I have a bunch of them, as to how we're going to make it year-round. The reason why I'm not going to tell you yet is I don't know which ones are going to work.
Right.
And until I know that,
mm-hmm.
With all the history that's going on here, if I start throwing out ideas and I don't do some of them, then I'm a liar.
Right.
I'm better. I'll tell you when I know what I can do. I'll tell everybody.
Close to the vest. Figure it out. Do the research.
Yep.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense. Any idea when you might break ground? When this might start?
Yeah. Breaking ground. We're probably 3 years away.
Okay.
From actually breaking ground.
Okay.
That's realistic. I mean, it's probably 18 months to do it once we start. You know, that's a reasonable guesstimate.
Okay. And you have any idea how much the whole project's going to cost?
Tens of millions. Yeah, yeah. For sure. We're spending almost $35 million in St. Clair. It's smaller.
Mm-hmm. When you got Sugarloaf last year from Remo Polselli, his name was still connected to the mortgage through a shell company in Montana, I believe. As far as you know, is his name still connected to any... Is it?
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I actually don't know. I know it was sold to somebody in Montana.
Yeah.
Don't know who it is. Don't care who it is.
Doesn't matter to you.
Couldn't care less.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't matter. You know who your mortgage? You know who your mortgage was sold to in your house?
No.
But right. I mean, I just don't care.
Right. That's in the past, and when you get ready, you buy the mortgage.
Well, when our bank comes in and finances the construction.
Okay.
They pay that off.
Okay.
Just like we did in Romulus and in St. Clair, where he held the paper.
Yep.
You know, it goes away at that point. But up until that, I make my payments, and I don't really care who it is.
Right.
Whether it's Wells Fargo or Remo Polselli, it doesn't matter.
Yeah. Yeah, doesn't change what you have to do.
It doesn't affect me at all.
Right. Okay.
And it doesn't give me any rights.
Right.
Unless I default, which I don't do.
So financing the project is something you're doing as you did in Romulus and...
We have to. I mean, there'll be, you know, nobody has this kind of cash lying around.
No.
So there'll be a financing stack. It'll be a complicated financing stack, and there'll be banks.
Yeah.
Probably more than one.
Mm-hmm.
There may be government loans involved.
Mm-hmm.
We may look at some EB-5, you know, type of situations with the feds. And, don't know all those answers yet, but I do know that it will be a financing stack with bridge loans and other kinds of loans.
Okay.
Polselli won't be involved in that. He gets paid off, and then he's, you know, or whoever owns
whoever owns the mortgage.
That gets paid off. It's all new at that point.
Okay. Great. And then the last question, what made you decide to come to have a public meeting today at 11 here in the county?
Chet, Patricia asked me to do it.
Okay.
I did it in St. Clair almost 2 years ago.
Okay.
To help quell the rumors and keep some public officials from having to answer questions every day. Mm-hmm. Once people found out that it was sold, and it was successful there because people were able to ask me questions, and I did my best to answer them.
Right.
And so I guess there's a hope that that'll happen here as well.
Okay. What's the name of your baseball team?
The Orem Owls.
O-R-E-M.
Uh-huh. Owls, O-W-L-Z. It's in Orem, Utah.
In Utah, okay. How'd they do this year?
I had the best record in the league, made the playoffs, and got beat in the playoffs. Happens. We've won 5 championships in 14 years. So
it must be well managed team.
We're doing okay.
Cool.
We're working on the next hand now for Riggs. So.
Yeah. Who's going to win the World Series?
Dodgers look real good right now.
Don't they?
Dodgers look real good.
Yeah, but the Yankees are just coming out.
I'm not sure the Yankees win in Houston. They have to show they can win a game in Houston. But I'm a betting man. I'd bet on the blue right now.
Yeah, I think you're right. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.